Standing with my back to the front door. Got tile here. Looking out towards the mountains. So you go downstairs or into the main living area. So we will look over to the main living area. Got a nice kitchen. Stainless appliances. Double ovens with the warming oven on the bottom. Gas. Prep sink over here. Here's your views out this side. Dining area. This is the back side of the fireplace. And your main living area. And there's the fireplace there. So big sweeping windows, big views here. It's really, really beautiful. So we have a powder bath here. Got a coat closet right here by the entry. Master is right here next to the side of the stairs. So you have the door out. Super windy. I don't know if you can hear that, but it's really windy today. Double bed. This is the walk-in closet. It does have a door on it. Look back there around the corner. Here's the master bath. Water closet. Got the walk-in shower. Soaking tub, and then double vanity. And then this is on the corner of the house. So you've kind of got the side and back views from here. That's your closest neighbor on that side. So coming back out, there's the front door again, living area. Down the stairs. I'll have to go back and do the utilities. So downstairs you've got this kind of like a metal tile floor. They have a little table here. But you've got a little sink, refrigerator area, closet for storage under the stairs. And then this kind of additional sitting area with that goes outside that way. And then a bedroom over here. And the good views out the back. This is just it's a small bedroom. Got the closet. It's like a queen, so you could probably just do a queen bed in here. And then you've got this three-quarter bath. Nicely tiled. So looking back out, you can see the bar, stairs, a little table. Go on the other side. We've got a little office type room here. So you could do a queen in here as well. I wouldn't do a king in here. I don't think it would be too much. Could also do bunks in that room. And then this is the third official bedroom. We've got the closet in there, and then the bunks, and the window outside. And the bedrooms are all carpet. They're nice carpet as well, nice and updated. So here is a hall bath. It's a full bath. We Got nice storage in here. You do have more storage in the hallway here as well. This is the utilities. And then the final non-bedroom. This has another door out to the patio outside. And in here, you could definitely do, I would do a twin. You could do bunks in here pretty easily if you wanted to. You might be able to do a queen. It would get tight depending on how you laid it out. But you have more storage in here. So I guess in theory, this could be a bedroom because it has a closet and an egress through the back door here. And so these are those floors. That room does not have carpet in it. So that's the whole downstairs. Let me go back up and get the area behind the kitchen for you. So again, we're back up at the kitchen here. So this goes back to the garage. Let me start here. This is obviously where they come in and out more often. You've got kind of more of a proper entry. The closet. And then the laundry. So you have like a pantry type storage here, and then a big sink, lots of storage, washer dryer, and counters. Come back out the garage, two car. I'm gonna go up to this loft area. It's finished, but it doesn't feel heated. They do up in this loft area have like a little workbench and stuff and windows. So I think you probably could turn this in sort of into like a studio type space if you wanted to. There's lights up there as well. And this is a proper staircase going up. It's not a ladder or anything. Sketchy like that. So that's the whole inside. I think we've got everything covered. Let me get you up at the ceiling here because I've done a nice job at this house. It's really nice. I'm gonna do some outside video for you.